tropical fish. They are what I consider the perfect pet. As you look at them, they are graceful. They swim around. They're looking for food. They're in wonderful surroundings. They're contained. No messes to clean up. No problems, really. Maintenance is relatively simple. Maybe a half an hour a week changing filters. And yet you can look at these fish and almost be tranquilized by them. They put your mind at ease. If you're having a stressful day, they will unstress you. And sometimes they're more entertaining than television. Now there are a few fish in here, primarily the eels, that like to go in and out of different places. They sort of fascinate you at times. And we can see this little guy down there poking out of his little hole. And then we have the bigger fish, the more colorful fish, that swim around and are very content with their surroundings. Now the nice thing about tropical fish is that you don't have to get emotionally involved with them. Now we're looking over here also, we can see another little guy poking his head out looking for food. Now their habits are intriguing. Each one has their own disposition as to far as what they like and what they do. The idea is to get the right water quality, feed them at the proper times, and you will be well rewarded. Now, as I said, the best thing about this is that you really don't get too emotionally involved. If a fish dies, you simply flush it, and the only regret is if you had it for a long time, you might be distressed at its demise. But always think of this, tropical fish have their own rewards. But we'll say goodbye today, and maybe there will be another ongoing chapter of tropical fish. Now, these tropical fish also can have names, but we won't go into that right now. And we will leave you with this and say goodbye.